Hello and welcome back to Proactive here at day two of Resourcing Tomorrow. I'm delighted to be joined here by Nigel Robinson, who is the CEO of Central Asia Metals. Fantastic to have you up here. How's it going?
Yeah, thanks very much, Tom. It's going great. Yeah, we had first day yesterday. It was a busy stand that we had. Lots of interest, lots of good conversations with people. So, yeah, it's great to be back talking to people physically, so to speak, after many years. I know we did it last year, but it still feels fairly new in some ways, yeah.
Well, everybody's been saying that this year's event is much busier than last.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I think we've noticed that as well, actually, on the stand. It was good. Yeah, it was a very busy day yesterday.
Great. So, before we get into what it is you've been talking to people here about, could you just get us up to speed with what the company does?
Yeah, the company, Central Asia Metals PLC, was listed on the stock exchange, the AIM market of the stock exchange, in 2010. We have two operations, one in Kazakhstan, where we produce cathode copper, around about 14,000 tonnes of cathode copper annually. We've been running that operation, and indeed we celebrated our 10-year anniversary this April, 10 years of production at the Kounrad SXEW. That stands for Solvent Extraction Electrowinning Facility, and produces pure cathode copper at very low cost because it's an in-situ dump leach project. 5 years ago, on the back of the success from Kounrad in Kazakhstan, we acquired an underground lead and zinc mine in North Macedonia, the Republic of North Macedonia, as it's now called, just slightly north of Greece in the Balkan area. As I say, there we produce lead and zinc in concentrate. Around about 20 to 22,000 tonnes of zinc we're forecasting for this year, and 27,000 to 29,000 tonnes of lead in concentrate. This is a more traditional underground mine. Again, low capex, low cost operation, and that's the second operation that we have in the portfolio.
Fantastic. So what's the plan for the business? Are you trying to increase production and find new sites?
Well, I think at those two sites that we talk about, we're reasonably optimised. I can maybe talk about Sasa, where we have a project to change the method of mining shortly. But the actual output of production is fairly stable as to what we currently get in terms of what I've just talked to you about there, Tom. So in terms of growing the business, I think really the growth for the business is going to come from business development opportunities that we see in the marketplace, and trying to acquire another asset to add on to the current portfolio.
And you seem to have one in mind?
Not specifically. No, we've been looking for many, many years now, and we continue to look. One thing that happened also this year, the debt that we took on to actually acquire Sasa. So we bought the Sasa mine in North Macedonia in late 2017 for $402.5 million. Of that purchase price, almost half of it was in debt, bank debt, and we fully paid that down this August. So we now have no debt on the books, and therefore we're looking to acquire another asset from that position of strength, effectively, a strong balance sheet, with no debt on the books. We've always been paying dividends back to our shareholders since 2012 now, so we've had 10-year track record almost of paying dividends back. And it's a question of finding the right asset in the right country with the right metals, which is a challenge, really, because we want to make sure that what we add to the portfolio is accretive for our shareholders.
Well, you say the right metals. It sounds like you're in a good position to be involved with copper, because I've been hearing all of yesterday how copper is really something that people are very excited about.
Yeah, copper's a great metal to be in. With the transition to renewable energy, etc., I mean, most assets of that transition require the copper as a transition metal, as they're calling it now, and the demand is only going to increase over the years, and the supply becomes ever harder, and I think that's why everybody considers it as a good metal. Zinc's also a good metal, and our strapline is that we exist, what's our purpose in life? It's to produce the base metals that are essential for modern living in a safe and sustainable and profitable manner, and copper and zinc are two key metals in which we would like to achieve that in.
All right then, fantastic. Well, I feel like we've got a good overview of the company now.
Yep.
So what's your objective for day two of Resourcing Tomorrow?
Well, same as day one in many ways, you know, to kind of network with people in the mining industry, to get the name of the company out there. I think we're quite well known in the London market, and also for look for business development opportunities, as I've just mentioned.
Well, Nigel, let me wish you the very best of luck, and thank you for coming up and chatting to us at Proactive this morning.
Many thanks, Tom. Thanks for your time.